11 women members of parliament from opposition were planning to hold a peaceful march moving from parliament to the Ministry of Internal Affairs so as to deliver a petition against police and other security agencies, which they say often frustrate their activities in their respective districts, especially the Women's Day celebrations. But they had barely moved an inch when police pounced and stopped them from proceeding with the walk. What followed was a scuffle and chaos as MPs were manhandled and their placards confiscated. However, female MPs gave police a hard time. Some of them traded punches with the authority. Police overpowered them and arrested 11 who were bundled onto a waiting pickup truck that sped off to Kampala Central Police Station, where they were detained. Upon learning about the incident, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, stormed CPS in full force and engaged police chiefs led by the Kampala Metropolitan Police Commander, Stephen Tanui, to secure release of the female lawmakers. Among asked police chiefs to always go through the office of the Speaker before arresting members of Parliament.
And the only issue that I want to request you is next time, as the head of the institution of parliament, when you're going to do any arrest on my members of parliament, your clerk has a course that you tell me, I am going to arrest so and so and so. You may not even need to arrest, you will tell me to deliver them.
Within a few minutes, MPs were released unconditionally and the Speaker led them back to Parliament. Led by Joyce Bagala, the District Woman MP for Mitiana, the 11 female MPs clad in black vowed not to relent from their campaign against police brutality.
As you're all aware, we set out on a number of activities to show our dissatisfaction over the way security, the RDCs, the RCCs, and indeed police have been treating us, female members of parliament. You know, some people have been talking about women members of parliament, but female members of parliament in the opposition, when we are meeting our constituents, when we are celebrating days like the International Women's Day,
in Parliament, the situation was not any different. The Leader of Opposition forced the Deputy Speaker, Thomas Taiwa, to adjourn the House sitting prematurely as opposition MPs piled pressure on the government to account for the police's actions.
Parliamentary officer breaking the law and nobody has touched him, even being escorted by ministers of government. I have seen NRM supporters demonstrating on several matters. I have not seen anybody touch them. Do we have the law for the NRM supporters and the law for the rest of the country? I want to speak
of the developments that we had today. I was getting a briefing whereby 11 of our colleagues, the ladies, were brutally arrested. Brutally in an extremely demeaning way. Some are bleeding. The clothes were torn. It was as if they were arresting terrorists. I don't know what someone was up to.
The Minister of State for Internal Affairs, General David Mohozi, condemned the arrest of the MPs in front of the police gate and apologized on behalf of the police force.
Guidance in the communication from the chair, and I do say, and Lop raised his sentiments, and I want to say from the onset that I share the same sentiments and concerns. I watched with consternation that clip. That brutality was absolutely not warranted. Even so, especially coming on the heels of Buvuma, including that it is surprising that it was done at the gates of Parliament. My view is that it shouldn't be done anywhere, whether in near Parliament or wherever, and against anyone, not just members of parliament. So to that extent, action will be taken. I want to promise this House action will be taken.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.